What's up, all you crazy mini bikers? I wanted to do a little video today about replacing those crappy foot pegs. And the reason why these suck is because they're made out of aluminum and it's easy to break them. And even a worse thing is when you're going through weeds and stuff, they get flipped up like that, especially if you have a torque converter. It's just a pain in the butt trying to always kick them down.
Ah, foot peg. Jeepers. Ah. Keeps pushing up my foot pegs so I can get my feet on them. There we go.
Maybe a peg upgrade might be good in the future. They're kind of slippery when they get muddy. Foot peg again. Yeah, these foot pegs are terrible. And these are weak, you know, they're made out of cast aluminum or something. People break them all the time, and I'm sure I'll break these eventually. So my goal is to get some heavy duty steel ones that have some springs on them. And I ordered a bunch. Well, I ordered two kinds. These were advertised as steel and they cost like, you know, 20 some dollars. Most you can get these aluminum ones for that look like this for like 12 bucks or something. They're really cheap. And with good reasons, because I think these would break just as much as the stock ones or even more, because look at that tiny little, and these are just cast aluminum. I actually got my money back for those, and I'll show you. And the guy kept saying, oh no, they're steel, sorry you're disappointed, I'll give you $3 back. And I was like, no, I want my money back, I'll send them back. And they just gave me my money back. So it's 100.9 grams or 3.56 ounces. They feel like they're made out of plastic or something. So I also got these at the same time that said they were stainless or something. I don't know. They're a lot heavier. So let's check this out. That's 8 ounces. Or 228 grams. I think the other one was 233 grams. So 228. 100. So I was like, cool, they must be made out of steel, right? Well, they're made out of something. They have steel in them, see? But they're not like completely steel. So maybe they are stainless, or they have some kind of steel alloy. Who knows? But you can tell they're a lot stronger and heavier. I mean, they're like, they feel like steel. I don't know. Anyways, I'm gonna use them because I got three pair of those, one for each mini bike. And the problem with these, there's an up position and a down position. There's this little bearing, and you know, this rides in there. It clicks up on a spring, and one's the up position, one's the down position, and that's all there is. And that sucks because they just end up sticking up. I mean, it's nice you can put them up for storage, but whatever, I don't really care. It sucks when they're just stuck up like that and you're trying to ride. And then they also, another thing that stinks about these is, of course, they get all muddy, and this isn't very grippy. These are a lot grippier. These have a lot more grip. And this style is fine. It's just, if they were made out of cast steel or cast iron, they'd be better. I have some of these, they're called craters or something, I can't remember. And those are heavy duty steel. I mean, they're not as good as CNC aluminum or anything like that, but they're, you know, people use these all the time and they're fine. And that's on my TW200. But the problem is, they're just a little too wide. You gotta take a couple millimeters off on a grinder right there. And then they fit right in. And these springs, it's like they give you extra stuff on them you don't need. You can see I cut a little bit off right there. And I'm going to cut this end off here because that doesn't need to be there. I'll just cut that right there. And this one came down and it was scraping against this bracket. So I just cut it off and sanded it or filed it down. But there you go. Now another thing is these pins were too big. These are the ones that come with it. And they're way too fat to fit through this bracket. So you could drill this out, but then you'd never get the stock ones back in there. So I figured I'd just try this thinner pin. And with all the spring tension, it's fine. It is wobbly when there's no spring on there. But with all that spring tension, it's perfectly fine. So I'm going to cut that off right there. Put a pin in, or put a cotter pin in, and boom. There you go. $20, something like that. Cheap, real cheap. And you got some heavy duty, nice foot pegs that you're not gonna slip off them. You're probably not gonna break them. And they're not gonna be always stuck up like that. The only problem is when you're parking all the bikes next to each other, they're gonna, you can't just have them stuck like that. But whatever. I think they do that for shipping more than anything. All right, I forgot to mention something. You don't have to grind those if you don't want. I'm probably not gonna with the second two because it's just a pain. You can just take a big old crescent wrench and bend these out a little bit. I'm not gonna demonstrate it too much because that'll get brittle. But yeah, you can just take a crescent wrench and bend these out a little bit, very gently. Probably wouldn't hurt to heat them up a little bit. That's one more thing you can do. See, this is the next pair I got here, and they fit in there without grinding them. If you just spread those out a little bit, so that's probably a lot quicker and easier if you want to do it that way. And don't forget to lube. I didn't mention that, but I put some chain wax in there and all the moving parts, and use grease or whatever. It's probably easier to just cut them like that and leave this little part there. I mean, you can do it the other way, but I don't think it hurts anything to leave it like that. It's probably easier. So okay, back to the video. There's a finished product. So that's sticking up a little bit there. But I don't think that'll hurt anything. You don't want to cut it too much shorter than that because it makes it real hard to stick this on here. You can see that one. Kind of just... Yeah, so that's perfect. Cheap foot peg upgrade. I don't know, $20, something like that. I'll put a link somewhere in the description maybe. That's like a must-do mod for these things because those other ones really suck. So here you go. Just want to do a quick video about that. Another little update. I covered all this with, I got this new header on here, which is awesome. But I covered it with header wrap. And this is a tube I wanted to try. A tube of header wrap, basically. And it works. It's better than nothing, but you could still get burned on that because it's so thin. So you might want to double that up or just go with a regular header wrap and wrap it up. But all right, I guess the next mini bike video I'm going to try to get a top speed run of this with the 8.2 60 tooth on there because I haven't done that yet. Oh, another thing that, I'll put that. This is that seat riser I made. It kept tilting back. There's nothing really holding it upright because I had it narrower than this. Kind of rode inside there on top of this bracket and this thing would just twist back. So what I did was just got a piece of wood, cut it out, drilled it, got some longer 6mm, I think they're M6 bolts or whatever those are. I just got longer ones. And there's my new seat riser. And it's only like probably a half inch, but it's noticeable. I might do a thicker one and then go all the way back here, because when I'm moving the bike around, I tend to want to grab this instead of the bar under there. And some, you know, if someone else is riding it, they're just going to grab this and eventually that's going to break. So I might extend it all the way back behind here. But it's about all the updates on the mini bikes. It's been cold and rainy and snowy, middle of May. Not much riding. So take her easy. Ride safe. Later.